Many people might consider this sort of clearance to be excessive, but here's why they might be wrong. If you've ever removed the head from an engine and rocked the piston back to forth in the bores, you may have been surprised at how much it moves. While your first thought may have been that this might seem wrong, it's likely that you've got nothing to worry about. To understand why there's so much clearance, we need to understand how the piston expands when the engine's running. The crown of the piston is exposed to a lot more heat than the skirt, and hence it expands more. When the piston is manufactured, the sides aren't actually machined parallel. There's a slight barrel shape to the skirt, and the skirt is wider near the bottom than it is at the top. When the cylinders are bored and honed, the clearance between the piston skirt and the cylinder wall is set at a point that's typically near to the base of the skirt, where it's wider than the crown. The aim here is that when the piston is at operating temperature, the clearance between the piston and the cylinder wall will be minimal, and all that excessive clearance near the crown will disappear. If you want to learn more about engine building, go to hpacademy.com for online courses.